Good morning, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Anytime now, we're going to be impacted from a CME coronal mass ejection that came off the sun, Earth-directed, within, say, now and the next 7 hours. Here we have the current KP index. This shows you how the impact will be impacting or has impacted the Earth, possibly interfering with satellite, radio, GPS, etc. Originally, they said the area that they gave the name 2962 was the location where the solar flare ejected from. But now they're saying down here at the bottom, 2964 produced a M2 class solar flare on March 11th, 2022. This event affected shortwave radio communication over the Pacific Ocean. It was a long-lasting solar flare that took place near the sunspot region of 2960, which is this area right here, and that occurred on March 10th of this year, 2022. This one right here produced an Earth-directed coronal mass ejection, or CME. The estimated time of arrival for the charged particles from the sun is today at 11:35 Universal Time. What I do to get a quick look at what time it is right now for Universal Time, I'll go to EMSC, and this is all Universal Time. These are earthquakes that they posted. The last one they posted was at 1349. That was at Panama, Colombia border region. So you might have a chance of seeing the northern lights, auroras, in the night sky. Earlier this week, another CME, which left the sun on Monday, March 7th, 2022, sideswiped the Earth on March 10th. It created an aurora display in high latitudes. Here we have from NASA an image of the solar flare that the particles are going to impact us today. That's that darker area right there. I posted this, I believe, yesterday, the day before. Another solar flare erupted today. It was a C5, and you can see it right there. Then there was another small one. 3:20 Universal Time is when it erupted from the sun. There was also another one. That one erupted yesterday. That was an M-class 2-3. Yeah, the sun seems to be a little active of late. For auroras, this is what spaceweatherlive.com is currently showing. They have another image, so probably only up there in Canada, Alaska, you'll be able to see the northern lights. Here we have a current image of the sun. This is that area that originally was not a sunspot that they gave it the name 2962, and they thought originally that's where the solar flare that will be impacting us today came from. But it didn't. It evidently was this one right here, and it was more centered on the solar disk when it let loose. And so that's why it's going to be a direct impact on us today. And as you know, it can create adverse weather, earthquakes if a fault zone is ready to erupt, rip open. Yeah, it could affect and create earthquakes, volcanic eruptions. And luckily, it's not an X-flare, because X-flares, they have found, will make magnetic mines explode. For the new followers, my last video that I did about this CME that's coming today, I talked about how during the Vietnam War, they had 20 to 30 mines that they had placed out in the harbor that all went off. And I suggest that you watch that video. All right, here is the sun-facing view of the current conditions, and it will show you right there. You can see the ring. Let me try and stop that. This is from the 11th, actually the 10th. This is the ring right there that is going to be currently impacting us. This is sun-facing view of the sun, and it will show the most recent two. Yeah, we got one off on the bottom there, one off on the side. All right, let me show you the other one. Here we have another view of the different eruptions, the CMEs from the sun. And you can see the time and the date down here at the bottom. But this will impact the Earth today. You may find disruptions with your satellite television, maybe fluctuations in power, GPS, things like that. So I want to thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.